What is up everyone, Jewelry here and welcome back to a new video. In this video, I'm going to show you simple ways to boost FPS in Genshin Impact. This is for those who have a low to mid-end computers, and these settings will reduce lags, stutters, and most importantly, it will help you to get a consistent FPS. In case you want more settings you want to try, you can check another video I made similar to this one. I will put a timestamp so that you can check it out. With that being said, let's get into it.
Alright, so the first thing you're going to do is to check if there are any available updates. To do that, simply go to your settings and then update in security and check if there are any available updates. As you can see, my computer is pretty much up to date. If you have any updates available, just let your system update whatever it needs to and then restart your PC. Most updates not only stabilize your computer, but they can also help stabilize most games for the most part. So updating your computer is one of the first things you should do. The second thing we're going to do is create a system restore point. To do this, simply type create a restore point. Then you should have a small option pop up looking like this. Then you want to go to your logout disk C and then click on configure. Then turn on system protection and then click OK. Then you want to create a system restore point by clicking create, and you can type pretty much whatever you want. In this case, I'm going to type Genshin Impact. Then click create. Then you're pretty much good to go. So if for whatever reason the settings didn't work for you, as in if the game feels slightly worse, or if you're getting FPS drops, or if the game just doesn't feel smooth, then you can pretty much restore the system the way it was before. With that being said, let's start off with the things you can do to boost Genshin Impact. Number one, go to settings, then go to system, then go to graphics settings. Then what you want to do here is to browse for Genshin Impact. In this case, I've already located the game. Then you want to click on it, then go to options. Then if it's set to let Windows decide, select the high performance and then click save. Number two, what you want to do is to head to your control panel. To do so, type pretty much control panel. Then you want to go to power options. Now by default, the power option should be set to balanced, but if that's the case, what you want to do is to click on the high performance. If you have a PC, you might have the ultimate performance tab. If that's the case, then click on ultimate performance. Number four, right click here and go to task manager, then right click on Genshin Impact and then go to details. Then you want to right click the game again and then set the priority to high. Number four, this is a personal preference thing, but what you want to do is to go to settings, then go to gaming, and then click game mode. Like I said, this is a personal preference thing, and I don't have game mode turned on simply because it doesn't help me get a lot of FPS boost, as in it doesn't give me a lot of FPS boost. But if you do use Xbox Game Bar for recording, then I do recommend you have game mode on. By doing so, Windows will optimize whatever game you're playing if you're using Xbox Game Bar. But since I don't use Xbox Game Bar for recording, then personally I have this option turned off. Number five, if you want to reduce the visual clutter in Windows and you want to have a more snappy Windows system, then what you want to do is to go to advanced system settings. Then you want to go to the performance settings, and then what you want to do is to simply uncheck the options you do not use for Windows, or for, as in like you want to uncheck the visual settings that you don't use or you find distracting. For me personally, I only have the smooth edges for screen fonts and show thumbnails instead of icons that on. Once you figured out what boxes you want to tick, as in what visuals you want to use, then simply click OK. Number six, we're going to target three files that collect a lot of temporary files. To do so, simply press the Windows plus R buttons on your keyboard, and then the first folder we're going to tackle is the temp folder. Then what you want to do is to delete all of these files. If you seem to not be able to delete some files, then that's fine. The second folder we're going to tackle is called %temp%. Then select all of these folders, then delete all of them. Lastly, the third folder we're going to tackle is simply called prefetch. Then what you want to do is to pretty much delete all of these files. Number 7. So as you can see, I am in game, and what we're going to do is we're going to simply optimize some of the settings in game so that you can get as much FPS as possible. Whether you are a low-end PC user or even a mid-end PC user, you can still try to tinker with these settings. So for graphics quality, you want it to have it at custom. For display mode, I personally run it at 1080p, so I'm running this game on a 1080p monitor. Now, if you don't mind, you could try to run this game in Windows mode if you don't mind, especially if you're experiencing a lot of performance issues. Yes, there's a small mistake that I would like to correct in this section. Technically, you can run this game in a borderless full screen. It doesn't matter what resolution you'll be playing this game. If you play this game at 1860 by 768, whatever resolution you'll be using, you can still run this game in a borderless full screen. To do that, there are two options. You can use the Steam method or you can use the shortcut method. For the Steam method, all you want to do is to open up Steam. Then all you want to do is to add a game and then click where it says add a non-Steam game and then click browse. Then you want to simply locate the Genshin Impact. Now do not select the launcher exe. What you want to do is to select the actual game. So in this case, Genshin Impact.exe, that's the one you want to select. Now I'm not going to do this because I already pretty much selected the game. Then it's going to appear on your game list. So what you want to do then is to go to properties, and then you want to add this command. I will leave this command in the link of the description. As for the shortcut method, simply locate the game, and then what you want to do is to create a shortcut, and then right click on the shortcut itself, and then go to properties, and then you want to pretty much copy and paste the command I mentioned earlier, then click apply, and then click OK. Once you're done, you can pretty much open the game, and then you want to go to settings. Then go to graphics. Now, like I said, it doesn't matter what resolution you run. If you run this game at 1024x768, then what you want to simply do is to hold Alt and Enter, and then you'll be able to run this game in a borderless full screen. Or you can pretty much select this resolution, for example. Of course, it will return back to its bordered window. So to fix that, just simply press Alt and Enter again. And as you can see, you'll be able to play this game in a borderless full screen without actually running the game in a bordered window. Now, of course, I don't recommend you go lower than 480p or even 400p or any of these, honestly, simply because not only will you have a small window, but you won't be able to actually see the entire view of your game. But what I personally recommend is that you run the game at its native resolution. For FPS, you want it to have it at 60. For VSync, personally, I have it turned off simply because it doesn't help reduce a lot of the stutters in the game. So I have it off. But if it does help you reduce a lot of the stuttering and lags, then obviously you want to have it turned on. Or this could be a personal preference thing, but personally I have it turned off. Render resolution is actually an interesting setting simply because it's not that different from render scale in games like Overwatch, for example, or any other game that has render scale. So what this setting does is it basically renders things at a given resolution. It doesn't matter if you play this game at 1080p or even at 720p or any other resolution, this setting is not going to change your display mode. It's just going to change the quality of the stuff that's being rendered in game. So if I were to put the setting at 0.6, for example, the game is going to render very poorly. And as you can see, I don't know if OBS will capture this, but as you can see, it's rendering things like very poorly. Like, I can tell there is a slight difference, but it's just going to render the game basically very poorly. But in return, you are going to get a lot more FPS and the game is going to feel a lot more smooth. Now, since I have a pretty good graphics card, the render resolution for me personally that works best is 1.2. Now, if I were to set the render resolution at its maximum, like 1.5, of course the game is going to look even better. But the problem is, as you can see, my FPS graph, I'm putting a lot of strain on my CPU and GPU. Not to mention that, you know, as I'm walking around like this, now I don't know if OBS is actually capturing this, but it doesn't feel that smooth anymore. And that's because, again, I'm telling my CPU and GPU to render the game at its maximum. So not only does it not feel smooth, but it also feels a bit more jittery. Like, it feels like I'm not playing at 60 FPS. And as you can see, the FPS as well is also fluctuating. So for me personally, I have it at 1.2. I find this to be the best. So depending on your PC, if you're low end or high end, you can try to tinker with this render resolution. Of course, if you have like a very bad computer, I don't recommend you play it at 1.5 because you're going to add a lot of strain to your CPU and GPU. So I recommend you try either 0.6, 0.8, or even 1.0. If you have a good graphics card, like a mid-tier graphics card, then you can pretty much try which settings work best for you. Otherwise, as for shadow quality, you want to have this at low or lowest since you want more FPS. Global illumination. This setting is fairly new by the time I'm recording this video, since we have the latest update of Genshin Impact. What this setting does is it basically makes the lighting of the game more realistic. And since I haven't done any tests to like show if it does make the lighting more realistic, for now you might want to set this setting off since you obviously want more FPS. Otherwise, yeah, just set this off if you are struggling with performance issues. Visual effects, you want to have this at low or lowest. SFX quality, I'm guessing this is like the sound quality. I can't tell if this will have like a performance hit. So what I recommend is you set this at medium at least, since you want to have the best sound quality. What environmental detail does is it tries to render one of the smallest details further away from you. So for example, cliff sides, monsters, or anything you can think of, even though you can see them from a high distance, you could still see them only if you have this setting at high. Now if you set this to low, you won't be able to see like the smallest details, like I mentioned, cliff sides, monsters, you name it. So of course, if you set this to high, then it's going to put a toll on your GPU since it has to render those smallest details even if you're far away from them. Anti-aliasing, you want to have this off. Volumetric fog, you want to have this off. Reflections, you want to have this off. Motion blur, this is pretty much self-explanatory, you want to have this off. As for bloom, personally, I have this setting off and it's not that different from like this setting that is like the latest setting, so to say. And bloom basically makes, like I said, makes the lighting look more realistic. But since there's no like actual difference, even if you have it or even if you have it on, most people recommend you set the setting off just to get a bit more frames. So this setting, in my opinion, will do nothing for you. Otherwise, you can just set the setting to off. Crowd density, you want to have this setting at low. co-op team effects. This one you definitely won't have it off, simply because, like I said, your GPU will do a lot of work to render a lot of stuff, and co-op team effect is the one that will slightly hog your GPU, so you won't have this off. Subsurface scattering, you won't have this at off. Anisotropic filtering, you want to have this at either one or two times, or like one time or two times.
And that's pretty much it. I hope these settings help you to get the most FPS possible. If for some reason these settings didn't help you, then you can just simply do a system restore point so that you can use the previous settings that you had before. Otherwise, let me know in the comments if these settings helped you. And if there are any settings I missed in this video, also let me know in the comments. I will see you in the next video. Take care.